I'm absolutely delighted to have Chiara Bowie with me from South Lanarkshire College, and Chiara is one of our fantastic tutors on the Access to Childhood Practice course. So hi Chiara, thanks for coming Hello. Along today.
You're welcome.
We're going to talk a little bit about HNC and making the transition on from the SWAP programme. Is it a bit of a step up?
Yes, it is a step up, but we try to prepare the students as best as possible throughout their SWAP course by doing their prep for HE, and we have talks from our HNC course leaders to talk to the current SWAP classes where they can ask questions and talk about applying for HNC. And they can give them a sort of overview as to what to expect. We've also invited previous SWAP students who are currently doing HNC to talk to our current SWAP students, and they can give them an idea of how they are finding it, because it's quite nice to hear from the students' point of view rather than always from the tutors.
What does the HNC look like, Chiara? How does it differ to the SWAP programme? What should the students be expecting when they start next year?
So HNC would be 2 days in placement and also two days in college. With their HNC coursework, they're more likely to be writing essays, assignments, reports, whereas in SWAP we do have a combination, but in SWAP we do a lot of sort of closed book assessments coming into college, sitting an assessment, and in HNC that differs. So there are a few reports and assignments in SWAP which helps prepare for that to progress on to HNC. With HNC, the students would need to be prepared to commit a lot more time to their individual study, on their study days. Because you do have to work from home, writing essays, doing lots of research and being organised. Organisational skills are really important because there'll be a much bigger workload and at a higher level.
That's interesting, because at the start of the SWAP year, we asked the students when they were working through their prep for HE, we had a couple of units about mindset and reflection and expectation, and we talked about time management and all of that kind of stuff there. So hopefully this year's prep for HE really helps the students to think about that. Do you think they have to kind of almost reset in their minds and prepare for HNC to have a look at how far they've come this year? Where should a student be in their own mind in terms of preparing for making that step up, Chiara?
I think it's important for the students to think about what they have achieved so far, because it is a big step to progress on to a higher level course, and it can be quite frightening for students to take that next step. It's a big step for them to apply for maybe SWAP in the first place, and then to apply for HNC is another big sort of step. But if the students able to think about what they've achieved so far within their course, and you know what they've accomplished from that first day, maybe sitting at a SWAP induction where they're feeling really nervous, not sure what to expect, and now you know they might have passed a lot of units, they've got the experience of being a college student, they've formed friendships, and that should all help prepare for HNC.
And does the actual class situation look a bit different to SWAP? Are there different students who come into the HNC compared to what the group of students that they're maybe familiar with from the SWAP programme?
Yes, so within an HNC class, there'll be students who have progressed from other courses. So SWAP, Access to Childhood Practice, there could be NC students, an NC in childcare. There could be students who maybe did an NC in social care and decided to swap over to childcare. You would have maybe people coming straight from school. You could have people coming from employment. So there would be a big range within the classroom, and it's good for everyone to bring their experiences. And we tend to put a few people from the same class together, so that if they are progressing from SWAP, that you already know a few people in your class, it helps you to settle in, but it's really nice to meet new people as well and share your experiences of your previous courses.
Is there anything students maybe could be doing over the summer in terms of preparing themselves once they've left the SWAP course? There's that long gap across the summer. What would you advise students to see?
I think just keeping themselves up to date with, maybe legislation, any changes, looking at sort of, childcare websites that, we advise childcare magazines that have the up-to-date information. You know, it's always good to subscribe to these, to read information, and just to prepare themselves, just working out ways that they can organise their time. So maybe if they found the swap course was quite busy, thinking, okay, so for HNC from the start of the year, once you know maybe what days you're going to be in college, how you're going to manage your time, you know, when can you fit in your studying, if you've maybe got a part-time job, how are you going to manage that? Will you need to maybe reduce hours? And sort of just planning to be organised as much as you can, because that will make the whole process much easier.
It's a really exciting time for our students. Any final thoughts, Chiara?
Yeah, it is a really exciting time, and it's lovely to see students progress from swap on to HNC and hearing how they're getting on in HNC. Just knowing that they, you know, they've got the confidence to move on, and then for them to be at their graduation, you know, a year later, and to think that they started off in the swap course, maybe a bit unsure if they were going to, you know, stay on a course that's all new to them, and there they are, you know, graduating and going into employment, or some going on to university. So just thinking you can do that, and it's such an achievement. So they should all be very proud of themselves when they've completed.
Fantastic opportunity, and we're delighted you were able to come along and chat with us today a little bit about what students can expect when they make that transition on. So thanks very much, Chiara. Thank you.
Thank you.